tigers, since it is World Tiger Day today. You'll have to check out our tiger trail. All species of tigers are facing the threat of extinction. So you'll have to be sure to check out our tigers. We do have special keeper talks and events throughout our park today for World Tiger Day. So be sure to use the back of your park pass as your guide on your way in. If you want to head to Tiger Trail right now and straight down this pathway, you'll run into our
brothers that want to say, yeah, I have reviewed like that's 22 and a half. And if you know our tiger, he is the standard. Yeah. Now that Nelson has left his litter at all, the request, they all scared us together. So mom asked Nelson to move out in April, and the girls came out later. So mom, from everything she thinks they need to know, and once she's finished with her job, she's kind of pushing them out.
And I'm one of the tiger keepers here at the San Diego Zoo Safari Park. Thank you all so much for coming out and joining us for Global Tiger Day. This afternoon for Lonka's lunch, he is getting a full beef shank. And I've hidden it inside of this cardboard box that our volunteers made for Global Tiger Day. And I've hidden Excelsior, which is the bedding material that some of our female tigers have scented over. So Lonka will have to use his great sense of smell to essentially hunt for this beef shank. In the wild, the tiger's lunch wouldn't be waiting for them on a silver platter. They would have to hunt down a sambar deer or a fully grown small carnivore. They'd fish and scream, they'd take down a bird, anything they could sink their claws into. So at the safari park, we want to make Wonka's lunchtime challenging so that he has to use some of the same senses and same muscles to get his lunch that he would need to in the wild. So I made him heat shake today so that he'll have to use his sense of smell to find it. Now Wonka has definitely played this game before. So I'm sure that he'll want you to be a little bit, see something you would use the better you can tell me that right away. So it'll be a very short step, but it'll be a bit more difficult than just putting the heat shake on a rock and letting him find it. In the wild, tigers are not eaters. They eat every part of an animal except for the stomach and small large intestines. So when the food to the tigers in the park, you need to make sure they have all of those different parts of the animal so that they get the full complement of nutrients that they wouldn't be getting in the wild. So we can't just feed our tigers filet mignon or hamburger meat. They need to eat all parts of that animal. So today, this beef shank is a special treat for Marvin. He gets bones and shanks like this, not only to strengthen his jaw muscles, but also to keep his teeth clean. These are basically toothbrushes for tigers. And these beef shanks will let Marvin do some natural ripping and tearing behaviors that he would use if he was hunting prey in the wild. So without further ado, I'm going to go back into the tiger house so that Marvin can rejoin me. And then I'll be up in the
Thank you. P-U-C-H-A-E, Puche means a fan. Chum, C-H-U-M, Chum means dance in Korean. So Puche Chum means a fan dance. My name is Don Kim. I'm a director of Korean Classical Music and Dance Company. Now we're the roster member of Los Angeles Music Center and also Orange County Service from Art Center, San Diego Young Audience. We have more than 5,000 performances so far. Next, we are going to have a folk dance. A dance with this drum. It looks like an hourglass. Sometimes people call the hourglass drum. The Korean people call it chango. C-H-A-N-G, chang-g-o. Chango is the name of this instrument. Korean word, the chang means a hit with a stick. Go means a drum. So chango means drum, play with the sticks. So chango have two small drums put together. Here's one lower to a higher. Two different sounds, just like the timpani in the Western musical instrument. And so we could adjust the tone using your strap. Highs go higher, lows go lower. Next, the dancer will carry this chango on their shoulder. They play this instrument and dance. We name the chango chum, you know, chum means a dance. This is a special folk dance. This dance is part of a Korean farmers festival. We call the Nola. After or before harvest or planting time, they pick up this instrument along with the other percussion instrument. They have a festival. This is one of the festival acts. Here's the Chango Chun. Jungle Dance. Thank you.